harvest. Oh God. The harvest is coming. The harvest is coming. The harvest is coming. I should wait on God. Behold, my help is coming. God is will do it. Hallelujah. Because you are a work in progress. I know something I've been waiting for, but I know the Lord is going to bring it to pass. This is my time. This is my moment. This is my hour. The King gonna bring it to pass. The Bible say, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew the strength. They shall walk and not be faint. They shall run and not be worried. If God is before me, Bishop, who can be against me? No matter what the enemy try to bring against you, this too shall pass. The same God that delivered me before, he shall do it again. I'm gonna make it. I'm gonna make it. I'm not gonna stop to achieve my goals. I'm not gonna stop till I step into my destiny. Because God will do it. God will do it. Hallelujah, glory to God. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High God shall we abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I'm not on myself, I belong to God. He's watching over me. He's my protector. He's my director. He's the head in charge of the ministry. He's the head in charge of the pulpit of the God of the kingdom. He knows your name. He knows you. Don't let nobody fool you. If God put you in the ministry, that is the ministry that is going to bless you. Don't let nobody play with your mind. Don't let nobody manipulate your mind. Because God has something in store for you in this building. You have to hold your faith. You have to believe. If God put me with the bishop, I'm going to stick next to him. Because I know my blessing, my prosperity, everything that God has for me is attached to this man. Listen, church. Listen. We have to come together. We have to unify. We have to build this together. We have to come as a unit. Because there is a destiny. There is a place that we're going. There is a place that God is going to do some magnificent thing for your life. You must hold your faith. You must trust in God. For Christ I live and for God, for Christ I die. Glory to God, he's going to fight my battle. He's a work in progress. He's not finished with me yet. But if he started something, he will be able to finish what he started. He's a good God. He's a marvelous God. He's the God of Abraham. He's the God of Isaac. He's the God of Jacob. He's a bright and morning star. God is up to something. Your name has to be written in the book of life. This is no time for game. This is a time for holiness. This is a time for sanctification. This is a time to live for God. I'm gonna leave all this package, all the garbage, all the trash behind me, and I'm gonna move forward into holiness, into a place of holy, into a place of sanctification. Glory be to God. Is a recoltable hand in me shit. Is a sarabaha. The Bible says it is not I that live, but Christ living. This is not about me. This is not about Bishop. This is about Christ, the King, the Savior of his people. He loves you so much. He died on the cross. They stretch him high. He paid the price for you and I. But Jesus, the great maker, hallelujah, Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith, he died for you. The Bible says when you're in trouble, I will be with you. Why? What do you mean when I'm in trouble? When you go into something, when nobody else can do it, but I will step in, because I'm God and I'm bad, I will deliver you. Hallelujah, glory to God. If you have any sickness in your body, God can heal that sickness. He can cast out that demon. There is healing in the name of Jesus. that he's healing. He's healing. If you believe, you shall receive a divine impartation from the Lord. Because, hallelujah, the Bible says, they that, hallelujah, have faith in God shall see marvelous things.
Hallelujah.
But you must believe. Because God is working something. Hallelujah. Because he's a God in control. Many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver them out of them all. I don't care what you're going through. God can get you out of it. He said, "God, I seem big and humongous. You don't know how can I get myself out?" But there is somebody I know that Jesus Christ can get you out of your trouble. Jesus Christ can get you out of the mockery. Jesus Christ can get you out of the mess that you are going through. It's bad. I understand it seems bad, but Jesus is specializing in fixing the badness. Because it's a God of Israel. He's a bright and morning star. He's a marvelous God. He's all by himself. He's in a class all by himself. Hallelujah. God's going to work it out. It seems bad now, but he's going to fix it. God's going to bring it to Oshadarabaha. God says he's going to bring it to pass. In due time, if you fret now, hallelujah, there's a vision. But I said the vision is going to be fulfilling.
Yes.
Glory to God, for the glory of God. And God is going to put the puzzle together.
Yes.
My God. I love the Lord. In Psalm 139, the Bible says, "I see your substance being yet unformed while you was in your mother's womb." He knows me. He knows who I am. He knows every little thing about you. Because he formed you. He made you. He's the head of your life. If you have a vision, God's going to bring the vision to pass. You got to have a vision. You got to have a vision for your family. And you got to have a vision for your life. And you got to have a vision for the ministry. What would you do for God? God make you rich for what? What would you do with the money that God gives you? Do you have a plan?
Yeah.
If you don't have a plan, you can only plan to fail. My God, you got to get yourself ready. You got to write it down. Write the vision. I'm speaking to some entrepreneurship. I'm speaking to some visionary. I'm speaking to somebody in here. Do you have a vision? Do you have a goal? Do there is anything that you want to accomplish with your life? Where are you going? Are you coming or are you going? Are you making things happen for the kingdom of God?
Write the vision.
Make it plain.
Yeah.
He that sees it shall win the bag.
Right.
But God is responsible for the whole entire vision. The vision is not yours. It's God that threw it through you. Yes. As you write it down.
Yes.
Then the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Then the Christ, the anointed one.
Amplify.
Oh my Lord, it will cause. And then it will execute the vision.
Yes.
So it could bring it to pass. So you could achieve your goal. So you can see that you're living that life that God always wants for you to live.
If it tarries, wait on it.
Always tarry, you have to wait on it.
Yes.
You have to humble yourself. And sometimes, once you have a vision, it will be in the flow. Sometimes people will walk past you. Sometimes people will walk on my car. Sometimes people will minimize you. Yes, but you have to still hold into what God gives you. No matter what happened, no matter what part it is, no matter how many deceptions you have in life, but you still have to press your way. Sometimes people will leave you, but it's okay. Because I have a vision. I'm going somewhere. That's somebody with a vision. You have to be welcome. You have to be strong in faith. No matter what happened, come hell and high water, I'm going to make it in broken pieces. Because I know that vision is God's given to me, and he showed me all those terry will bring it to pass at the right time for me. God is the God of prosperity and deliverance. If God called you into ministry, He have a plan for you. And He have something in store for you. When I got saved, I didn't know much. But the preacher told me that He loves me. I said, me? Ain't nobody loves me. But He loves you. He loves you. When God say that, He meant it. He loves you so much. The agape love. The unstoppable love. Now we have many love. Anybody can say they love you. Baby, you look good. You're beautiful. I'll do anything for you. I will take you out. There's emotional love. And there's foolish love. But the love of God is unmeasured. The love of God is unstoppable love. The love of God is a glory love. It's a godly love. Once I love you, I will not betray you. I will stick next to you. I will watch over you. Not only you, your children is in my hand. If you do your part, God will do His. Glory to God, because He's a God in control. He's a God that sustains the universe. The moon and the star. He's the one who in charge. If God can, everything that holds the heaven and the sun and the moon star is the power of God. If God can hold things together, imagine what God can do for you. Your heavenly Father possesses all those things, heavenly wares, because He's in charge of it all. Because He's in control. He knows how to put things together. In the beginning, God created the earth and the heaven. The earth was without form and void. Darkness covered the face of the deep. But God said, let there be light. And it was light. He's a marvelous God. He's a good God. One thing I like about the Messiah, when He started something, He will finish it. Nobody can stop what God has for you. Nobody can hold you down. They will try no voodoo, no jujubon, no hoodoo, whatever the heck they try to do, it will not stop you, because there is a power of God that will burn of all guys with fire of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah, Jesus. I don't know. If God is before you, who can be against you? I don't care how many people hate you. I don't care how many enemies coming against you. They shall come in one place, and God shall spare you in seven ways. In Jesus' because the Jehovah Jireh, He is a provider. God will not stop working for you. I know, Lord, I'm going through something. Sometimes I don't know what to do. And I have some weakness, God. But He's a God of all ages. He's an ancient God. And He's a humongous God. And He's a God of Abraham. He's the God of Isaac. He's the God of Jacob. If He started something, I guarantee you, He will finish it. Told you something, God is up to something. And sometimes it's obvious, although we don't see what happened. Because we live in a physical realm. My God. And there is a spiritual realm which is invisible. But when you live in a visible realm, you can see anything. But there is something that happened behind the scene into the spiritual atmosphere that God is preparing something specially for you. I'm waiting for it. What do you mean, Bishop? I'm waiting for it because I know it's mine. Because my name is imprinted in it. God, what you're praying for is already released in the third heaven. Listen, when the angel appeared, gave an appeal to Daniel, and the angel mentioned to him, the first day you get on your knees to request something from God, we already released the message. But I was in contact and trouble in the atmosphere with the Prince of Persia. He fight me, but thank be to God. There is a Michael, the archangel, come to deliver me so I can bring you the message. It's a fight. It's a fight. I don't care who you are in the ministry, we're going to a fight. People you love the most, they will spit against you and they will fight you. There's a fight. Yes, spiritual warfare. have to affect the body. Sometimes us ministers, we fighting demon not in us. The enemy don't want us to preach the gospel. He's coming against us in all kind of ways. Because it's a spiritual battle. If it's not your husband, it's your wife. If it's not your wife, it's the children. If it's not a church, it's a church member. I'm preaching good. You will be under attack. People will say things about you. You don't even know me. How can you say that? The devil's a lie. That's what they do. Because people will try to discourage you so you don't work the work of faith with God. Because I'm going somewhere. Yes, sir. God will put the puzzle together. Because I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, and Him will I trust. Surely shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence that will come. But God is going to put an edge of protection. They will try. The enemy will attempt. He's always going to try something. The enemy is always going to try something. But you must stay prayed up. You must have a prayer life. You must have a prayer life. If you don't walk, if you don't have a prayer life, the enemy will move you behind. You must consecrate your life to Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you don't have that, man, you're wasting your time. Sometimes even your husband could say, you're crazy, you pray too much. But I'm praying for God to help me because I know I'm going to something. I'm praying that God will cover you in the blood. You have to praise the truth. That's what I believe in, sanctification. I believe in holiness. Without holiness, no man will see God. I'm not the one who said it. It's in the book. It's in the book. We have to live according to the words of God. Hallelujah. The Bible said the flesh, make a provision for the flesh because the flesh profited nothing. Make no provision for the flesh. Hallelujah. Because the flesh profited nothing. I will lift my eyes unto the hills from which cometh my help. My help coming from the Lord. My help coming from the Lord. Don't help me coming from anybody. I was foolish to think somebody or my friend, my cousin could help me, Bishop. But he didn't have the authority. He didn't have the right. But God is the only one who can really help you. No matter what happened, no matter where your life told you was meant, no matter how many rejections you've been through, no matter how many doors slid in your face, God is the only hope. My hope is built on nothing less but Jesus Christ, my Savior, the Messiah. God is watching over this ministry. This ministry is planted to win soul for the kingdom. This is a saving ministry. God built this for a reason. And we're going somewhere. It's not too late. I don't care what nobody says. God have bigger things in store for the ministry. Jubilee of praise. God is up to something. We're going to cross over to 2020. I know you've been through some hardship in 2019. But if you fake now, you're going to make it. You got to hold your peace. Thank be to God. He's a wonderful God. And He will help you. The Bible said, "Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, not for the hour that fly by day." Spiritual warfare. You're in attack. You have to be covered under the blood of Jesus. You have to worship God. You should not listen to circular music. You should always listen to the gospel so you could be filled with the Holy Ghost. Fill me with the Holy Ghost, Jesus. Envelop me, God. Teach me how to live right. Teach me how to be right. My God, my God. So I can become the man or the woman that you were created me to be. God created you to be a disciple. Yes, you. You're a disciple. You have to evangelize wherever, even you're at the marketplace, wherever you go. You have to evangelize.
Amen.
You have to tell someone or somebody, Jesus loves you.
Yes.
You have to evangelize. You have to speak the words.
Yes.
Because the heart about Horiba. The Bible says, it is your father's vision. It is your father's good pleasure.
You.
Oh my God. Amen. To give you the key of the kingdom. Well, if I have a key, therefore I have access. What would you do with the access God gave you? Because you already have the key. My God. You must utilize what God gives you into perfection so you can accomplish the kingdom of God. Our purpose in life is to fulfill the will of God. There's a difference than the gift of theology and psychology. Psychology has its part, but theology is the realness of teaching the words of God in season and out of season. Because God gives you the key. Once you have the key, you have access. But you have to unlock some doors. I don't know why I'm saying it like that. Yes, you have, if I have keys, I can unlock some doors of my blessing. If I have the key, I will open the doors of prosperity.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord, I don't want to live in poverty anymore. Oh, glory, I'm going somewhere. If I have the key, I'm going to leave with the possession of God and to do what God wants me to do because I have keys. I'm not moving in the flesh. I'm moving in the spiritual realms. I'm going to accomplish my goal. And I'm going to accomplish all of my dream. Because I'm focused. You have to focus sometimes because people will bring destruction. Sometimes when you're going somewhere, you don't tell everybody all about all your business plan. They will discourage you. You don't have what it takes. It's too late.
Amen?
Don't get into distraction. The devil's a liar. You will miss what God has for you. Because you have the keys now, you got to be able to unlock some doors. God's going to open a door. Oh, Reba. God's going to open a door for you that no man can shut.
Yes. Believe it.
Hallelujah. They try many times, but God's going to open this door this time that no man can shut.
That's right.
And you will walk in it. And your life will never be the same more. Thank you, Jesus. I praise the Lord. Thank you for using me. Thank you for the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. I pray that you will bless everyone, every members of this ministry. I don't know why I'm doing this, Bishop. Raise your hands. Are the sounds of my voice, are the queen and the glad, a special blessing, even as your soul prosper. I pray the God of heaven, the God of Abraham, richly bless you with all spiritual gifts. And I pray that the Lord will help you to possess the land. Wherever you step, God shall give it to you as a heritage. Father God, I pray for your people. I bless you. Everything you touch, I release the blessing. Everything you touch, we'll talk to go. God bless you.
Clap your hands in the ground.